Excellent. Good.
Good.
All right. There's our admin. There's our HR. There's our HR department, guys. The admin is coming through. So magandang hapon. Thank you for being here. So yeah, we did some tare, right? And actually, maybe Dan and Eric, you could show me a little bit more or some of your reflections based on it, right? So we're saying we got the pendulum, we got the forward movement, the backward full pendulum, right? But we're adding on the tare at the end of the pendulum, right? The ball is a little, it's shorter, so it's cutting my pendulum down. So actually, I'm not going to use it right now. So we're going to say that you're going cordon, neutral, and then the tare, right?
Yes.
And the idea of the tare could be in between, at the end, but it could also be in the middle, in the beginning, after your cordon. Cordon, you could go forward in tare, and go back, right? But for now, we put the tare at the end, okay? So, I guess we'll do that. I want to put you guys doing, I want to start you, having you guys do the moral footwork as well. Oh, not my bad. Whoops, retract that shit. The moral stretches and the moral walks. The moral walks is the line. The moral line is what we call it. And this is just like the terminology we call it because this was the drill Sonny had given us, right? And that's what we just kind of called it, that term. But yeah, that's really about alignment. And that's when you really start putting it together in terms of connecting the lower gates and the higher gates. Okay, so before we do that, let's just do a quick salute and then do the foundations and then go back to tare and then do some of the mortal stretches and drops. So we'll be doing a lot of like solo body work, not too much on the ball, just to kind of start working on body alignment and structure in terms of the system as you kind of grow into the system and what it start to look like when you start kind of putting things together a little bit with your footwork, your handwork, or your blade work. All right. Okay. Thank you, gentlemen. Marami salamat. Thank you for being here. Let's just do a quick salute. Look forward to training with you today. Make sure you let me know if there's any questions, okay? So let's start off with our sun salute. Just doing the star foundation right quick. Neutral. All right, we're gonna do the V steps. V step, puntaria, two rotations. Half body pendulum, shift your body weight. Puntaria, make sure you pull out of the center line there. Back to neutral. V step the other way. Two rotations here in the center. Half body pendulum forward, shift the body weight. Pull that back foot out of the center line, out of the way there. Back to neutral. We're gonna do the V steps, side steps. Okay. Yeah, how did you guys feel about that tare workout last week?
It was good.
Started to look like Muay Thai a little bit, huh? Oh, where did Jay go? He just bounced on us. Back to neutral. Side step is opposite side. Two rotations here. Half body pendulum. Pull out of the center line. Back to neutral. Okay. We step back. Bulgaria to upright pendulum backs, get out of the center line there. Back here. Oh wait, I'm bad. Jason's on the way out. Okay. Okay. And then forward, cordon, cuerdas. Yeah. Way forward. Make sure that back is aligned parallel to the center line, right? And we could also do it where we're pulling out of this, pulling the back foot out. You know, we have that variations too. Yeah. Where that's back to return. Forward follow. Let's do it again. Back around the sun. This time with the weapons. One through 11. Okay, from Mudral, we're gonna do our V step. Touch the right shoulder, shift the body weight. One, lua, tatlo, pat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu, labing isa, back in the ground. We step the opposite way, touch the right shoulder, shift the body weight, begin, isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu, labing isa, back to neutral, forward follow, side step, shift the body weight, touch the right shoulder, begin, isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu, labing isa. Side step the opposite way. Touch the right shoulder, shift the body weight. Begin, isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu. We step back, neutral. We step back, touch the right shoulder, begin. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu. Back to neutral. We step back the opposite way, touch the right shoulder, shift the body weight, begin. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu, labing isa, back to the right. Cordon and cuerdas, from the front. Go forward, shift the body weight, touch the right shoulder. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim, ito, walo, siyam, sampu, labing isa. Back to the front. Cuerdas, step in backward. Touch the right shoulder, half body weight back. Begin, isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, ani, ito, ulo, siyam, sampu, Vinisa. Back to neutral. Okay, relax. Right. Let me see. I was just watching myself. I was like, wait, I need to lean in when I was doing a sidestep. Realize I'm a little vertical right here. I really want to lean back deeper like this. Like, probably want to do more like this. That little on you. See, I want to kind of be in that angle. Right. It's okay again to be in medium range, right? Instead of like long range. But we want to, like in a drill, I want to condition and train myself to do those long ranges, because those are going to be more challenging than the middle ranges, especially doing a lot of okay. Like really leaning back on some of angling your body. But I definitely caught myself. I was like, oh shit, I need to clean up, because yeah. Because that's the drill I'm asking you to do. I should do the same thing. All right. Cool. Any questions regarding any of those exercises? Okay. Let's do some pendulum work. Actually, yeah, okay. What time is it? We can do some pendulum work, and then we can do the motor stretches. No, we could do that first. Okay. Let's see. All right, let's do this first. Let's do the tare, and then right. Cordón, neutral, cuerdas. Okay. So let's do the foundations right quick. There's cordón, neutral, cuerdas, tare. Okay. Again, like toes could be pointed this way or downwards, right? Pointed at your opponent or downwards. And then the bartender adjusting their shit. Me too. Okay. Cordón. Neutral. Cuerdas. Right, so you see how the knee's kind of pointing down, but you could also point the knee at your opponent once you know identify an opponent, right? But in this case, just keep your knee pointed down, heel up next by the buttocks, right? Now those could block lower kicks like these, right? And parry them as well, right? And then, I remember we actually lowered the ball too, right? Okay, we'll probably do that later. Or Eric, have you been able to adjust to have a ball that could adjust? No, not yet.
Not yet.
Okay, that's all good. Yeah, we probably, it's all good. We'll do it a little later, guys. We'll, because there's a couple more things that I want to kind of do right now. So, but let's do the foundations again from neutral. Right, cordón, neutral, cuerdas, tare, tare. Okay, keep going. Okay. We're gonna switch at Bordon from here. Switch. Now you're penduluming. You're doing a pendulum pivoting on your right, leading with your left. And then, so you're gonna tare here. And you pivot. All right. And see how my elbow and my knee is aligned. Switch up top. Move that right here. Okay. That's the foundation. Now, like if sometimes there might be a kick that's coming like this, where it's coming this way, then this could be then could block and cut and shield up as well. So it could shield up like this, right? Right. So there's many different ways that this tare could be a shield. It could parry and deflect this way or that way, going this way. Right. Guiding it out, parrying it. Okay. But for now, the basic would be just stepping back, aiming with your elbow and your kneecap towards the opponent, or work towards where the center line is, whether the center line directly where he's coming at or the center line of his strike, right? Whether he's doing a hook, he's doing a straight punch, he's doing a kick to the knee, whatever that attack, that becomes the new center line, right? Aside from his own center line, there's that strike angle, okay? So then you use your tare, right? And you kind of aim it to whatever is coming. So for this drill, we would obviously do it at Uutare and aim at the ball, right? But for now, let's see. Let's do this. Let's keep going with the drill right quick with the pendulum. Okay. So I'll go this way. I'll boom. Then we'll do tare. We're gonna switch on cordon from here, switch. And we're gonna tare when we go back here. Right. Switch up top. Now when you go back to pendulum, tare. Later we'll do some stuff where we'll go pendulum, tare, and then go back in the pendulum, keeping the pendulum, right? We go, we cordon. After we cordon, we're playing with the timing a little bit, a little advanced, but after you cordon, you you do a tare in the front right here. Back, and then you're back in the pendulum. But we'll do that later. Right now, we'll just kind of time it in the end here. Let's do a switch at cordon. And then tare in, okay. Keep going. Okay. And all right, so relax for a little bit. So the tare, see how I have, you see how I blade my body? So instead of just doing this, I turn, right? Right, and Sonny would say he kind of got it from cockfighting, right? The chickens, you know, with the blade and the blade in the back of the, you know, because he would tell stories about how some of the Filipino warriors would train with and with blades connected to their feet, whether it's at the bottom of their feet or the top. I remember training with Sonny where he would have a little contraption around his foot, around the, he'd wear his wrestling shoe, and on his the tip of his boot would be like a knife coming out like this, pointed up like that, would edge down though, right? Edge down like this. So like, would be like on his shoe, right? And he would have us play like that. He would like wrap something where we was inserted in our shoe or right in the threads, right where your shoe would be in that thread part. We'll just insert it right on our. So we would play like that, right? He would have us play like this, and then what made that what kind of and then sometimes the edge would be like this. We just insert it through the shoe, right? And then sometimes his little contraption, the edge was down. So it was like this. And those two things made a hell of a difference, right? Not like good or bad, but just like a difference. So then we would then start having us use our foot the same angle of the blade, right? So then he would like start having us treat our foot like with the blade. So we was just like, so those little nuances and small little meticulous little details gave a lot of like, life into the footwork, right? Because then it's not just like this flat foot walking and doing the pendulum. Then it's also like angling your foot a certain way and landing certain parts of your feet, right? Forward, the number one, the moro, right? Where it's like, you know, it's like an angle one, right? Your foot's like an angle one, right? And then number two, it's a vertical, right? Or at least your toes or just forefoot. And then the third key is like this kind of bladed, right? Like a sidekick.
It's 6 o'clock.
Right, so you're, right? So even those, you start to kind of start seeing it and feeling it when you were apply your footwork to your blade work, to your pangamot, right? And to your just overall movement based on blading your foot, right? There's another concept now. It's like, okay, now you're blading your body. Now you're blading your foot. Right, you're blading your weapon. Okay, now you're blading your foot. So there's like, there's this other thing that you're adding on. So yeah, so the tare he added on as a defense, and he kind of connected to the cockfighting in the Philippines, where they put blades on the chickens, not the chickens, the roosters, right? So now that's the tare concept. I mean, our concept of defending. The tare could be a defense, it could be an offense, but for the most part is defensive, okay? So now we'll just kind of do some quick pendulum. We'll do a tare, and then we'll come in with any of the three keys, okay? Whether it's one, two, or three. Right, for the number one and the second footwork coming in. So then you like number three and number two. So after a tare, boom, you go number three as you step in, boom. And then you put it down. Is that could be a step three. That could be a kick to the ankle three. That could be a kick to the kneecap three. That could be a kick to the rib cage three, right? And so you do a 3-2. So as you step in, right, you change your body angle. Now you're coming in with a two. So this is when I might square up, right? But then I come up with a two step, just a two step, right? Or a two kick to the ankle or the foot jam, or a kick to the kneecap forward step, or a kick to the rib cage or the hip forward step, right? So we say three tare, then 3-2. So boom, then we go Tres, three, two, boom, back to the pendulum. Again, tres, three, two, three, two, three, two, three, two, two step, three, two, right? Then we'll, so yeah, and then as you put your foot down, and then you can shift your weight forward and backward, okay? So let's do that, we'll go slow. So we're executing the keys, the footwork keys forward in the pendulum. Later we'll do executing keys backwards, right, in the pendulum, going where that's movement. You can go three, two, pendulum again. Three, two, right? And then that two brings you to the three. After you do two, boom, then you tre. See how I change my body angle in mid-air? I go boom, then I go boom, right? Cover up right there. Yeah, like that. Okay, so let's do some of those drills. If you can, so Eric, you look like you don't have a ball anyway.
I got one. I just was getting it out of the way. I'm ready for it.
Oh, okay. So go ahead. If you can't bring it down, if not, you just work, just do the movement, right?
I got it here.
And what we're doing is we're working a little bit on pendulum, some footwork. With the kids, I call it talampakan. Talampakan in Tagalog means footwork, right? So maybe once we go more, as we expand it more, we'll start calling it more talampakan, because sikaran is, it's a little bit more, it starts to look dangerous and stuff. And for kids, we wanna hold on to that stuff for later, you know. So you'll hear me say it, you'll hear me call it talampakan, which is literally means footwork or footsteps, actually. Okay. So I'm gonna bring it to, usually my three favorite places are like ankle height and knee height, right? And then because I'm shorter. But then when if I wanna work on my like dexterity and some more my athleticism, then I'll bring it up higher. So I might bring my knees up, right? Start to look like start to look like Muay Thai a little bit. Yao Yan. Right. So for this one, I'll probably bring it around a little above the kneecaps, right? Okay. So right now, what I'm doing, what we're gonna do, is just measure with the tip of the kneecap or the pendulum tare to the ball, right? Oh, you did bring it down, Eric. Okay.
I found a bungee cord, so I just connected it. So.
Sweet. Okay. So this is what I'm looking for right here, guys. Right, this sharpness here. Right, I'm going to switch up and do this profile shot here. Right, look how where my toes pointed, either at the ball or down at the ground. Right, like half an inch away from your kneecap. Right. For you, Eric, that works too, but what you're doing is more, you're raising it up. You're raising up your knee higher than the ball, which could work if you're, you're defending you like a rib shot, right? Then you wanna bring it higher. But if you can, point downwards. See how my kneecap is pointed downwards at the ball? Yeah, just to build good habits, let's do that. Keep your hands up. All right. Okay, so this is the tare. The tare is a defensive strategy that could be offense, that you could jam them. But from here, then you can start releasing a number two. So I want you to go tare, two, right? Two and two is going forward, two and two. Right, there's two steps forward after. Now, if you can, check this out, guys. I seen you guys angling in it with your getting, I understand your distance with the ball, which is great, right? Once you start understand more that your distance a little bit more, I want you to start sharpening up your angle to the ball, right? Instead of squaring up like that, I want you to kind of like, whoa. See how I turn, how my hips and my shoulders are parallel to the center line? Now, you still could do it squared up a little bit, right? Going forward, where you're squared up, there's hips. Both your hips are across each other from the center line and your shoulders, same. But if you can sharpen up a little bit, angling your body, my shoulders and my hips become parallel to the center line. Boom. Boom. Nice, Eric. Yeah, there you go. You're parallel on off of the center line, which is good. That's good. You want to be out of the center line, yeah. Mm-hmm. Try to touch.
You come back in with the cordon. Are you perpendicular again, or you're?
Yes. That's one way. Yeah. Right. You're perpendicular again, you know, right? That way you're starting to identify. Now you could be bladed again, or you could be on one side of the center line again. Eric, you go like as soon as you boom, then you could be like boom, boom, right?
Okay.
I kind of step across, and yeah. I'm here now. I'm parallel, right? So you could be that sharp. Okay. Yeah, you could be that bladed if you'd like to, right? Sometimes I like to lure my opponents. So I square up, I look all dull, you know, like, hey, I'm right here. And then later I'm like, boom, boom, then I'll sharpen up and I'll
okay. Leave,
you know. So I would say explore both of them. But then if you are stepping out of the center line, right, if you are going to be offline parallel, try to minimize your movement so you're not like super hella far away, like out here.
Okay. Right?
But you're more like, you're like super, like really thin, really close by. Look how my toe is right next to the stick instead of like all the way out here, right?
Yeah. You could shoot up on that same side that you're on too, huh? Like here.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Right. Coming in. Yeah. Yes, exactly. On that same side, right? Because then you're bladed. Then if there's an angle one coming at you, right, instead of being inside angle one, you could be outside angle one. You could be like boom, right? You could step out, you could be bladed.
I'm not sure I understand.
Okay, so let's give me 2 minutes on this drill, and then we'll go back, and then we'll work on some other tool exercise drill that will then help a little bit with alignment. That's one of our tools in terms of troubleshooting, measuring, etc. Okay, so now we'll include after the tare and after the second. After the tare, it's number two, right? Number two, and then number three. So it's gonna look like this. After tare, number two, number three. Okay? Again. Number two, number three at the end. Okay? So, tare, two, three. Okay? Now, yeah. Yeah. What you're going to notice is it's harder to pull away unless, you know, yeah, unless, you know, you don't make contact and you got to kind of get out of the way, get out of the scene, right? So after two, three, after you leave it there and you just pull back. Or you put it, you touch the ground, right then you go, boom, touch the ground, and then use the ricochet of your foot on the ground to put you back into the pendulum, right? So it's like, right? Or you don't overcommit. And you kick, you leave your kick or your step in the air, and you pull back out of the pendulum, boom, boom, then pull back, okay? Now, the way you're gonna accomplish that is after you kick with a three, you use the momentum of your heel to your buttocks when you pull back, right? After you do this one, boom, this one. Right? After you kick, you try to hit your buttocks back with it like this. Boom, boom. And then this one, right? You use the, momentum and then you shift your torso so you get a torque out of it. Are you guys getting what I'm, can I show you guys right quick? It's a little much actually, maybe it's a little bad. So from here, right? After here, pull back like this. Right, that momentum carries back and you turn your hips. So you're back in the moment, you're back here, okay? This is kind of super, a little bit more challenging and difficult stuff, but just include it, just kind of feel how that back motion can pull you back, right? Think about it like, let me give you guys a different angle here. Okay. Yeah, this is far more challenging, guys. Sorry. what is this movement where you're like, it's like de cuerdas moving. You're whipping, it's a whipping back, and you're using the momentum of your heel. Right, so that one. So this one. this one. Okay.
So Sunny would have us do this. Yeah. Okay, perfect. This is actually gonna feed right into our next
thing because okay, check this out. Sunny would have us do this drills. Well, he'll have us on something similar to,
not like this, but it's a circle thing that has some ball bearings in the middle, and it's like a lazy Susan. It's like a lazy Susan in the middle that it twists. And he would have us stand on top of it, right? He would have us stand on top of it and try to do our mortal spins. And so he would have us like,
huh. Right, and that was about alignment and like momentum, right? So I remember fucking it was years he had us doing this shit, but so he would have us do these exercises. This is the mortal, what he called it, the mortal drops, right? This one. Right? And that's probably my variation to it. But he would have us do these things where he would have us find alignment and see how, and then he was like, okay, these are like some of the foundations on how some of the mortal spirals and spins kind of played a role, and a lot of that was alignment of your points, your wrists, elbows, your shoulders, and gaining momentum and torque from these movements, right? Right. So, okay. So that's gonna transition us to our next thing, actually, which we should do now, actually. So okay, first of all, let's close out what we were doing. We're aligning the center line. We're seeing the center line of low lying attacks, right? And then we're aligning our defensive strategy with the ball. Okay. And then after that, we're starting to come in and we're coming in with intentional talampakan footwork, kicks, sikaran. That's kind of start making us move forward with more intention. It's like, okay, I'm going to come in with a number three and then another number three, right? So that means if we're going to be bladed, that means there's a lot of turning of our torquing of our body, right? Of our hips. And et cetera, right? And putting those combinations in. So we just did a combination of a tare and then two and three. So we did tare, two, three, right? And then we're having some challenges escaping. And part of that is because we're either dropping our weight, we're overcommitting, or we're having a hard time torquing, committing, and finding our exit back. And one way we can do that is start finding those alignments again of the upper and lower gates. This, because when you start turning, your body and you include your elbows with your hips, then there's torque. Then there's like torque, right? So that's what's going to help us in some and getting off some of our footwork is getting those torques, including that escape of like that one. That's a lot, man. I should have saved that till later. So I'm sorry. But it's just the concept of, right, kick and then leaving it there and then using the heel to hit the buttocks to gain the momentum, the torque, so that I can pivot. Yeah. Right? Okay. So that's what we're doing. And that's a lot of shit. That's a lot of fucking work. But now, so now what we'll do is another drill that's going to be valuable in your overall scrima, in your overall martial art, but specifically to our system, okay?
which is the motor walk. Motor. So that is, I think this one I'll probably pull this out. My good old fashioned son, AKA office mat. Okay, so we're gonna do a number one, right? Where your toes pointed that way, right? And my kneecap is gonna be right in the crevice at the back of my knee here. So I'm gonna give you a profile shot here, right? From here, here. I'm gonna give you another opposite profile shot. Here. Here. Okay. This is square. So now my right elbow is going to be towards the center here. So I'm going to give you a direct shot. Right elbow right here at the center. The right hand is on my shoulder, creating that triangle. Right. Now this could also be like this, combing the hair, protecting the head, right? Or here, touching my shoulder, which is just like parrying. Right, this is a parry, but I'm, for this one, I'm gonna sharpen up, create this triangle, okay? Now, what I do is I aim down at my lower gates, and the elbow then touches the knees here, boom, okay? Okay? Before even the knee, the elbow touches or points at the hip, my left hip, and then the left knee. All right, so it's going, boy, this elbow is, I'm wearing black, so it's probably hard to see, but it's gonna try to point to this hip. All right, so I'm super bladed. And then go, yeah, guys, looking good, looking better. Okay, so then I'm gonna follow this angle. This is my new straight line right now. Then the kneecap, right? The inside of the kneecap, because my foot is open, my leg is open, inside of the knee. Okay, and then just to clean things up, my left hand, I'm just gonna put it on my hip as if I'm pulling out my knife here, but I'm gonna open up, so I'm gonna do like this, from this angle. This one, yeah. Well, you guys got this shit. Look at you guys, looking good. Okay, so from here, if you can, you don't have to, you can build up to it later. Sunny would have us, you know, angle down to the ankle. Right, and then back up, okay? The next level to that is like, you know, shit, you fucking elbow to kneecap, elbow to ankle, and then, you know, still creating that angle, right? Still creating those angles, right? And then, you know, he's like, he challenges people, you know, he's like, if you can, your right shoulder touches the ankle. So you don't have to do it. Oh, fuck. Oh, I should have never had that drink last night. Oh. All right, sorry. Just kidding. So this is boom, right? Boom. This is the motor stretch, okay? When your right shoulder aiming for the, and you're trying to connect it with your left ankle here, and your left shoulder with your right kneecap, right alignment. Okay, but that's something else. That's motor stretch. Right now, we're going back to alignment, which is here, here. Okay, what we were doing now. Going back up, so from elbow to ankle, then elbow to back to kneecap, and then back here. Okay, so that's one part of it. Okay, once again, from neutral. And then you do the other side, obviously, right? We'll do, once again, ready, again. So then I'll just step back and just, right?
from here, I go boom, boom. I start to tilt down, elbow points to my left hip, and then to the elbow, from elbow to the ankle, right? Then I slide down to the kneecap, then I slide to the ankle, then back up. Okay. Now from here, you walk through with a number two step. You go, you see this hook? Yeah, you see how I came in from here to here, and then I hooked. This one to this one. Yep. And then come in with a number three. Right? Profile shot. From here, I go boom, and then I come with a number three. Right? From three, I go to two. Boom. See how I changed my footwork from three to two? Now I kind of square up. And then to one. Boom. Here. Right? I'm gonna take this out. I'm gonna step on my stick, but pretend that there's that line underneath me. Actually, I'm gonna move back here. So then you do the opposite side here now. Right? You see how I'm like, see how I'm creating triangles here? Right? I could be a small triangle here, could be a small triangle, or a wide triangle here. All right, so boom or boom. Now here I do it again. Touch the right shoulder with my hand, elbow points at my right hip this time, and then elbow goes to the kneecap, and then elbow slides down to the ankle. Right, and then here, by the way, the kneecap should be sitting at the crevice of the ankle here. Right, and then back up. Do it again, move forward, come in with a number two, drop the number three, back to a number two, do a number one, do it again. Until you can walk across the living room or your backyard.
Guru Jay, quick question.
Yes, sir. So
when you have the, let me see what's the best angle for this. When you have the elbow on the knee, this knee's in the back of the knee, and then as you slide the elbow down, the foot slides, the knee slides down to the ankle.
Yeah, but it cradles. It cradles behind. That's what makes... That's more of the motorcycle. It cradles behind the Achilles.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? It other part of the moto style. That way, the indigenous moto warriors could hide behind tall grass, right, and still be spring loaded. They'll be still be spring loaded. You see how my kneecap is
Guru Jay, are you talking about like almost like a ball and socket kind of relationship?
Yes. A ball and socket relationship.
Okay. So it's resting on the Achilles or yes. In that pocket on either side of it. It's kind of like
right here, sir.
Right there.
Yeah, that well look at me, look at my so right there you're so if you could be right on top, right here.
You're just out of the frame. Right there, got it. Yep.
Right, okay. Right in the center, right in the middle, at the bladed part of that Achilles, right? Because then you're spring loaded, right? That's why our system, Sunny would always say, and I would always be curious why there's a lot of different systems like PTK. They all, you know, they do a lot of stuff. They drop their, they drop to the ground. And Sonny was like, we never want to do that. We said, Sonny said, we don't drop our knees to the ground because we might hurt ourselves, right? So Sonny was like, so the concept of the moto style is, you know, you're like on a landing pad on the Achilles. That way you can spring load, right? So when you drop, the warriors would hide in the grasses, and then they could just spring load and chop heads and back in the grass and hide out, right? And then boom, and then they land in this particular way of landing on the Achilles. So then you don't hurt yourself doing this, right? So. One other drill had Sonny would have us do, you know, when we were there for a few years, he would have us balance on one foot.
Damn.
While lifted. Nah, should have not went outside last night. But, you know, that shit is fucking hard still. And I'm like, I'm not getting any younger, you know. So once you get alignment down, once you get your alignment down, then you could do that. You could balance yourself because you got your close like that. Yeah. But you still want that kneecap, Dan. You want that to be on top. You want that to be on top of this guy. Right?
I wasn't quite there. Yep.
Yeah, but excellent. Fucking homework for 20 years, guys.
Shit. My knees hurt watching.
Just what's that?
So my knees hurt just watching you.
Oh, sorry. So for folks with stress challenges with knees, right, then you could still use the concept of the alignment of the points, right? You see how, like, the kneecap is behind the other kneecap, like a ball and socket, and where the kneecap is right on top of the Achilles, like a ball and socket. Like, it, like, fits right perfectly, right? So it's like, boom. Right. So there's like that place that it cradles it. So for the folks that are having knee issues, what you do is you still use the concept, but this time, instead of going down here, you stay up here, knee to knee, just knee to knee connection, these two. Right. So like Silat, you know, you're like, boom, 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 boom. So for our FMA, boom. That's why the other reason why our Sonny have us hooking like this. Right, because then it cleans up our foot. When you're kicking somebody straight, you don't want to show them and telegraph the kick. So you hide it, you slide in. Right. And then the hooking, you don't want to hook yourself and trip yourself, but it's just a way, like the sickle. It's like the sanggot. Right, then, like, just like how your foot could be a knife, your foot could also be like a sickle, like a sanggot, and that's what that's doing, right? And then you don't hook yourself, you slide, you go, boom, right? So that's where the turning of the hips come in, right? You go, boom, right? It's just a drill. You don't hook yourself, but it's just a drill to hide your foot. So when you kick in real time, you go, it's hard to see. Instead of telegraphing big, wide kick, right? Sonny's like, walk through, then insert your kick, right? Walk through, or with a number two, right? Or with just a knee, right? Side knee, number one knee, right? Number three knee, number two knee, number one knee. Right? So they're then extending it with the foot, for example. Okay? So the mortal lines is a drill to start finding alignment. Later in your weapon work, then you also identify power a little better. Because then, especially your largo, then you start putting power in your step, in your number one, in your mortal. Of course, you could just boom like that with a number
3 or number 2 or number 1. Right, we're then changing. So now the right arm is the longer weapon. Right? Hella shit. Sorry I went all over the place today, guys.
Well, that was good.
But I do gotta wrap up. Let's do some quick reflections. Thank you so much for going through that. Yeah, let me give me some questions.
So you don't see these as two separate arms? Two separate arms together.
You guys are getting it as one. But it's two separate arts. But as a full martial artist, a complete martial artist, you make it become one. But can I wrap it up? Of course. Right. It's two different lifetimes, with just an open hand and then also with the sikaran, right? But the idea is to complete them, right? The idea is that they're one. They're one. Your footwork and your sikaran, right? Boom, boom. Right? Your blocks, etc. Okay? Go ahead, Eric. Anything else for you, sir?
No, it was good.
Yeah? Okay. Yeah. Anything stood out specifically today for you?
I kind of liked at the end where you're actually blending it with the Largo and kind of bring it all back home. So you're showing the.
Excellent. Yeah. So in that case, when you go into that, just a couple more, just another minute. So then you're aware, like, okay, I'm striking forward. I want to elongate my part. My target is further. And then it's maybe smart to do a number 2 footwork. Right. Because you have number one. You know, sideways, that'll work too, but then you're kind of bladed. So that could work as well. But if you're going to do a number 3, I got that shit confused. But then if you're going to do a number, a moro, a number 1, right? Right? But then as you elongate, then you turn, right? And then you can do number 4s too, right? Eventually then, boom. Right. And then that's what we'll see some of the moro drops where you're hitting it and you're doing a moro drop and you're doing a power strike. You're doing like super powerful strike going, right? Yeah. Yeah, I can't wait to get you guys in a little circular thing. That's going to be testing level 4. I'm all right, level 4 testing. I need to see you guys spin on the moving man. You need to be on there for 2.5 seconds, guys.
Who's got the original one?
I'm not sure, man. I don't even know how he built it. But a lot of it got moved around to different students' homes, you know? Yeah, I don't know how he built that stuff. But yeah, go ahead and let's do some more reflection. If you're done, Eric, you want to pass it to the next person?
Sure. Jay, what's going on?
Okay. Stretching wise for my back, I did notice that doing that moro stretch was really helpful. Ooh. I do a version of that. It's called a pigeon stretch where I try to go from here and really just stretch down.
Mm-hmm.
What happens is I get that muscle that goes through to get a good stretch. So when I was here and I was putting my elbow to my ankle, I can feel the same stretch. So it was pretty good that way.
Flexible guy.
On the Largo. I don't know if you saw, but I was at a barbecue recently.
I did. I was like, look at this guy.
I was here and I managed to pull that off quite a few times and it was sweet. I even pulled it off from here where I came upwards and nobody seen it coming. It was great. And then there was a couple times where I was like this and I just tapped and
nice.
So it was kind of fun to play with that.
Yeah.
But I also started seeing that if this is the center, one of the things that really started to work was instead of doing it on this side, it was coming in this way.
Mm.
So I almost wanted to get behind him because I was thinking he's going to be moving. He's going to be moving like this towards me. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to go back to back and sort of just clip him. And it worked a few times, didn't work a few other times.
Yeah.
But that bullseye really was sweet. We did it with stabs, so I got a little extra reach. And it was really cool to pull off. So nice. That was one thing. The other thing...
let me know if you get any videos of that specific time.
Yeah, I'll send you some stuff.
Okay,
Okay. With these mats, barefoot, it's really hard to pivot. I stick to the floor. So I put my socks back on, but I'm too slippery. So I'm going to have to try this outside. So, but that kicking, I found that problematic because when I was here, the foot just doesn't want to, you know, move. So I'll have to do that somewhere a little more conducive to spinning.
So here's a suggestion for that, right? Lift your weight a little bit.
Lift your weight a little bit.
So your foot is not
flat.
So lift your weight a little bit.
Or you see how
kind of I round up my hand.
Right.
Or lift your weight a little bit
more
as you pivot. So then your foot is not sucking down to the ground, right?
Okay. I see what you mean.
Right, and one
breaking the seal.
One way to do it is unlock
your body, right? Like
so,
unlock my hips and my kneecaps, right? And that gives me a little
bounce.
So imagine the more fingertips and the more things you have on the ground, so lift it
and there's less contact. Right.
Okay, I'll give that a shot.
So I do a little bounce, a neutral movement, when I lift, and then that lifting allows me to get momentum.
Maybe experiment with that.
Good stuff, man. Excellent. I'm glad that you got to pull off some of those stuff. Real time.
Yeah.
Excellent.
It was fun.
Awesome. Awesome. Yeah, send me some videos when you get the chance.
Will do.
Dan?
Thank you, sir.
All right. So the biggest thing I noticed today was, you know, you had us work in like the third point, second point, first point in reference to the ball with the upper body. And today when we were doing the this one here, I noticed every time you moved, that front knee was tracking that ball. So I started to see like that second point on the lower half is just like the second point on the upper half. You know, when you were doing this and then stepping in, it didn't just like step randomly. You kind of brought it in with the ball. And I saw you tracking with the knee. Mm-hmm. So you're like rotating the hip and the ball and socket joint there, tracking the ball with that knee as you came in, and then on the way out too. So it clicked, you know, today watching that, where I was like, okay, there's three more joints of the body I have to align more precisely than what I've been doing. So now I have to really kind of pay attention to that knee and like almost like a turret, you know, and just track center line.
What is a turret? What is a turret? Is that the tip of the gun?
It's like the thing on the top of a tank.
Oh, excellent. Excellent. And what is the thing at the tip of the gun? The aim, what is that called?
Barrel?
Yeah, barrel. Is, what about the little pin thing that sticks out?
The sight?
Yeah, the sight. The sight, the turret, that's exactly, good observation, Dan, is exactly what you're doing with your lower body, right? And what you see me doing is I'm passing it off. I'm passing it off between my two points, my third point, my first point. As I move back and forth, I'm passing them off. I'm trying to minimize not tracking it. Maybe even if I don't make contact, like I'm still at the sight of it, right? So like even here, like my, even if I'm not hitting it, like you're right, I am tracking it, right? And then I'll pass off between this knee to this knee. You see that? I go boom, boom, right? Boom, boom, from a two and number one, right? Number three, number two, number two. So then when you start doing combos, it starts becoming easier because you're tracking it the whole way, right? Even if you're not making contact, you're still tracking it using your points, whether it's your foot. Your knee, right? Or even your hip. Right now you connect with your elbows, your fist, right? Then you start putting it together. Then you connect all of them together, right? So passing it off, trying to have less time breaking away from it, even if it's not touching it, you know, like continuing to track the pendulum and then passing it off between one joint, the other joint, one point and the other point as you track the pendulum in and out. Good observation. Anything else, sir?
No, that was the big takeaway tonight. It was like, you said it before, but tonight I saw it and was, you know, trying to do it. And I was like, that's what he's talking about.
Yeah. Then it's easier to pull off like number four, you know, you're like, boom, 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 boom. You know, you're like, oh, number four in the mix, right? Because then you start understanding it. So then when you start to include the one that's the most difficult one, because you're fucking using your tail whip or whatnot, like, then you start to training your eyes. And same thing with that. Then that's your heel, right? Passing it off, right? Going from the heel to the knee. Passing it off from point to point, right? But trying to the less choppy, the better, right? So try to move in there, in and out, smooth, changing your range and having smooth transition with rolling on the balls of your feet, right? Unlocking. You know, all of the things that the fundamentals around the pendulum, right? If it's too far, then unlock, neutral, get closer, you know, use your other knee. Oh, I'm too far from it, right? Then take a bigger step. Oh, you know, then you have a lot more to play with. Excellent. Anything else, Dan? Yeah, no, that's right. Last week I got excited about this shit. I was talking hella much. Okay. All right. Well, thank you, gentlemen. If there's any more questions that come up, you know, we're doing a tare, but the tare allows us to see what comes after a defensive move, right? What comes after? We already know what we're going to do with our hands, you know, but what about our foot? What is going to be, what's going to come after? So we're looking and looking for intentional spaces to be, to place ourselves, to position ourselves. And then if there's a strike, great. Then we just extend that step, that key into a kick, right? But the alignment of walking with the moto allows us to start finding our center, finding, you know, aligning this and that, finding our balance point, right? Finding our center, like, oh, it's too close or too far, right? Or aligning my elbow and my knee, right? Blading your body, so all that shit, that's hella shit. Hell of shit. Okay. Thank you. Wa alaikum assalam, guys. Is there a salute? Thank you so much for training with me tonight, and I hope you and your family have a good rest of the week. Feel free to send any questions that one might come up for you, and I appreciate you spending time tonight, okay? Salam alaikum. All right, gentlemen.
All right,
great training with you guys. Hope it was fruitful and useful.
And, useful. Nice.
It was great. Have a great night.
Yep.
Take care.
Thank you.
Take care.
See you soon.
Good night. Magandang gabi.